Steve. Oh, oh. I'm a wild boy. Ain't I need? Oh.
Eastside Cleveland wild boy. We got baseball bats like the Indians, and my team pop off like cowboys. You a white flag, throw that towel, boy. I'ma jump right in that crowd, boy. I do a shh, keep it down, boy. And I'ma blow that loud, boy. Snap back with my city on it. Text back with your on it. Levi's with your kitty on it. Start crying like the clips is on it. Drink until I get pissy, yo. Until I get dizzy, yo. Lose control like Missy, but I'm a bad boy cause I'm with Diddy, that's John Doe. Never mind, that's just Kells with that heat. No LeBron Doe.
Yeah, yeah, Bill. Call me Steve. Oh, yeah, yeah, Bill. Call me Steve. Oh, I'm a wild boy. I'm a wild boy. I'm a wild boy. Ain't I need? Oh, yeah, yeah, Bill. Call me Steve. Oh, yeah, yeah, Bill. Call me Steve. Oh, I'm a wild boy.
Timmons.
He's a stern one.
Oh, you know I am. Last Friday's game was a big one between the Stallions and the Staff Snipers. The Stallions, though having a promising start, beating a grade 12 team, just could not stand up against the Staff as they spanked them.
Spanked grade 10 teams. Colonel Gray High School, let's go. Monday, there was a huge game in between Cotton Ball Kings and the Leftovers. Cotton Ball Kings clutched up to win the game 6-5.
Well, I'm really not going to go on to you and say how I'm really not disappointed, because I am ticked off at that loss.
Ticked.
I really hope that this is all just a nightmare and I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and it'll be all be sunshine and rainbows.
There's one thing you like, it's rainbows, buddy. One thing he likes, it's rainbows.
Final score was scored by Harrison Ross, or Tie-Dye Lightning, as Tim and like to call him.
Do you like the nickname Tie-Dye Lightning?
I'm very indifferent, but most everybody likes to call me Bird.
How do you feel about going ham on that game, just winning that clutch OT goal there?
I feel pretty good about it. Yeah. Decided to go right off the draw and shoot on net.
Oh, he is Tie-Dye Lightning. He goes up and down that court like the speed of light. At the same time, that tie-dye just distracts the enemy. He's the ultimate player.
Cotton Ball Kings have been practicing 3 times a week to pick their game up, and hopefully they'll have a good season.
Oh, that they are.
Well, we feel pretty good about this, you know, because we worked hard for this. I mean, we practice 3 times a week, and it just shows that hard work pulls off in the end. It really does.
Great to see. This is possibly one of the most energetic games I've seen all season. Do you have any comments to the other teams, knowing that you may be coming in as the underdogs, but it looks like you might be a force to be reckoned with?
Well, see, this win is going to give us confidence, and whoever we're up against next, we're coming for you.
Tuesday was a hard-fought game between the Goons and the Clusterpucks. It was the Clusterpuck season opener, and they proved to be a force to be reckoned with. Between the Goons, it's the last game of the season, and they had to bite the dust. Clusterpuck said they didn't play their full potential, and hopefully they're going to be playing better the next game.
Yeah, we weren't playing very well defensively at the end of it, but we pulled out the W at the end.
Yeah. They had a lot of pressure on us at the end, but we stayed in it. Our goalie stayed was strong.
Oh, what, it's my turn? Okay, cool. I gotta keep my hair as the captain's defeated Arcee's gang.
Texting a woman, are ya?
Well, that I am.
All 6 of them.
We played pretty well. Could have done better. We'll work on that in practice. Hopefully we can keep going. Yeah.
How do you feel you're going to do this season? Is this affecting you guys throughout the season?
No, no worries though. So I think we're gonna make it to the finals.
Just gives us more practice. We are really a hardworking team for a bunch of different people.
Still having the team meeting tonight at Wendy's, 8 o'clock. Frosty's all around.
You know it, Murphy's discount.
Actually, we changed it to KFC, so I get my favorite chicken.
The Captains win 3 straight, taking them to the playoffs, and they are a force to be reckoned with. And it looks like I might just keep these curly locks.
Maybe it's Timmons, maybe it's Maybelline. Today's game is between the Black Aces and the Poly Pockets. Looks like it's the end of the road for both teams, as they've lost all their games.
We might as well just call this episode the Biggest Loser, because both teams did not win anything.
Biggest Loser, weren't you on that show, Timmons?
Oh, you know me, I was a big plump boy. Now I'm a big, plump, delicious man. And honestly, I think people should stop sending me friend requests, because I'm not going to respond to them. That's my Facebook page, not my fan page.
After some allegations about the staff snipers they sent in this video.
Roll the clip, Steven.
You know, management had to make some tough decisions. We have another 48-year-old on the team, Mr. John Louis Arsenault. As far as Gordy goes, you know, respect him as a professional. But, you know, on the court, I think the clip really speaks for itself.
So I bet my hair on you guys winning, but I already did that, so.
Well, you have nice hair.
Oh, well, thank you. I know it is. I'm so low.
There's an outtake right there. Please, no. Lavalite right here, Alex Timmons, Lonely Man, like long walks on the beach, fire, and polycock.
Alexander Daniel Joseph Allen, Easton Timmons.
It's way too much information.
Yeah.
That is my last name.
That ain't the last half of the freaking phone book, buddy. All the time. Every day I come to school, and Timmons just starts hitting on me. I'm like, no, Timmons, leave it for your sister. Hey, I'm not married yet, Timmons, okay?